Hi, I'm Kirk Davis, a specialist solutions architect on the Microsoft platform team at AWS. Today, I'm going to show you some of the powerful capabilities of Amazon Q Developer to speed up .NET development in the IDE. Amazon Q Developer is a coding and conversational assistant powered by generative AI that can help you develop, extend, and understand applications for AWS. Q Developer can chat about code, provide inline code completions, generate new functionality. It can scan your code for security vulnerabilities and make improvements to it. Q Developer is available in a lot of different places, depending in part on whether you're using the Pro tier or not. Today, I'm talking about using it in your IDE, but you can also access Q Developer from the AWS Management Console and other places where you work. It's also built into Amazon Code Catalyst, AWS's unified software development service. Amazon Q Developer's code suggestions are based on large language models, or LLMs, trained on billions of lines of code, including open source and Amazon code. And Q is constantly updating its capabilities to give you the most contextually relevant answers. If you're a .NET developer, you probably spend your time coding in one of these IDEs, either Visual Studio, VS Code, or a JetBrains IDE like Writer. So Amazon Q Developer is available as an extension or toolkit for each of these. The toolkits for VS Code and JetBrains IDEs support all of Q Developer's features, while at the time this video is recorded, the AWS toolkit for Visual Studio supports the code generation and code completion. But our toolkits team is busy building the interactive conversational features into that toolkit too, though. So if you're watching this video after summer of 2024, it's likely already there. One of Q Developer's great features is code explanation. So if you've ever had to work on a code base written by other people, possibly years ago, and you struggled to figure out exactly what a method or a class was doing, Q can really help you out. You can just highlight the code that you want explained and ask Q to explain it. And then after it could take a couple seconds and then the explanation appears, Q actually gives you a full explanation of the code. So in this example, it gives me a quick summary of the code that I selected, a line-by-line explanation of what the code's doing, and then it provides some high-level background of what code like this is typically used for and why. So in this case, the actual method was getToken and it was generating a JWT token. Q not only explains all that, but it tells me what those tokens are used for. They're usually used for authentication and authorization in a web app or an API, and it talks about the private key signing the token and so on. Q can also write code for you. So in this example, this is an ASP.NET controller. I need to add a method to update an existing order in an application I'm working on. So I actually wrote the method signature and I put in a comment, like a to-do comment, update existing order, and I hit enter. And that comment then serves as the prompt for Q, which looks at the rest of the code in the workspace and on the in this file, and it sees that there's, create and delete methods. So then it suggests the code to implement the update. It knows that there's a DynamoDB client defined in the class already, so it uses that. And then I can just hit tab to accept the code and move on to my next task. So potentially my next task might be, adding a method to save a product image to Amazon S3 in this hypothetical e-commerce app. So another way you can supply a prompt instead of a comment is just type some code. And here I was adding a method. I typed out the method signature to save a product to Amazon S3. And based on that method signature, where I'm passing in a byte array for the image, Q suggests the code to upload the file to S3 using the transfer utility from the AWS SDK. And when I was doing this, I didn't even remember exactly how to do this. I would have had to go check the docs or do some searching. Using Amazon Q Developer, it sometimes feels like pair programming, and the other dev has a better memory than I do, right? Now, one of the most powerful features of Amazon Q Developer is the agent for software development, where you can go from a natural language prompt that you type in to an application feature with interactive step-by-step instructions right in the IDE. Because Q understands your workspace structure and it uses your prompt to create a plan to accomplish whatever you're asking with logical implementation steps, which can include generating new code, creating unit tests, doing API integrations, and more. You can collaborate with Q to review and iterate on the plan that it creates. And then when you're ready, Q can implement each step, generating new files and updating existing ones. So in this example, you can see I asked Q to create a new class in C Sharp to save a log of all the JWT tokens that are generated in that app I was showing a little while ago, and to save the log to Amazon DynamoDB. So once I did that, Q developed a detailed plan. Now the full plan is too long to fit in a screenshot, but you can see that Q created this series of steps, including creating a new token logger class, importing namespaces, creating a log token class to persist it to Dynamo, and so on. And you can give feedback. Like before you implement the plan, you could say, hey, don't create the unit test if for some reason you didn't want to test the code, let's say, which I actually do, of course. So when you click the button to execute the plan, Q creates the new files and updates existing ones. So using Q can almost feel like having another developer to offload your tasks to, which is great. You can also have conversations with Q, asking open-ended questions. So in this example, I asked Q about using React.js with .NET, and it gives me a really useful answer with a bunch of options. And before I did this, I didn't even actually know there was a React.js.NET library that you could use. And another thing, you can ask questions about your code, about AWS services. And an important thing is Q even shows you the sources it used to generate its answers, which is really useful if you want to go back and check out the source material. So you can get started with most of the features with the free tier. And unlocking the full potential of Q Developer Pro is just $19 a month as of summer 2024. Let's see a couple quick examples in Visual Studio and VS Code. For the demo, I'm going to start with a project in Visual Studio 2022 called Gadgets Online. We use this ASP.NET Core website, or a project, I should say, to do some workshops around modernization. And it's a sample e-commerce project or website. So if I open up the shopping cart controller, you can see that it's just got a couple of methods in there, add to cart and remove from cart. And let's say I wanted to add a new method called empty cart. So if I just go ahead and type in the signature, public action result, let's see, empty cart, and then I can see that already Q is suggesting this code, right? It's going to get the shopping cart just like it did from the method. Like you can see where I did that in the methods above. It's going to call cart.emptyCart and then redirect. And this is actually the exact code I would write if I was writing this method. So the interesting thing is it sees Q saw the two methods above, so it knows how to get, the cart, an instance of the cart. It knows about the underlying shopping cart class. So if I click through this, oops, if I click to this method empty cart underneath, that's in a different class in a different file. So it knows that that method exists. And then finally, it can see from above that after doing, anything with the cart, that it's supposed to return redirect to action and return the index page. So that's a pretty simple example, but it was a lot quicker than me typing it out. Granted, with me talking about it, maybe it took a few extra seconds. But you can see that Q really did put the same code I would have done before I even finished typing the method signature. So now I'm going to try to ask Q to do something a bit more substantial, like create a unit test. So for this, I'm going to switch over to VS Code because it already has the developer agent feature in the toolkit. So this method that I'm looking at here, it's part of a project that's a Lambda function. This method is checking whether a request signature is valid, so it gets passed in a string body and a bunch of headers. It's basically checking to see that the headers were signed with a SHA-256 encoded version of the bytes of this is a sample secret, obviously not a real secret, but just one we were using for this sample application. So if I switch over to Q here, and I'm actually going to make the Q window a bit bigger here. I know it's not super convenient on this small screen, but that is what it is. I'm going to go into the slash dev and click slash dev to get to a dedicated developer agent window here. And then I'm going to go ahead and type in my task, which is create a unit test for that is signature valid method, pass in the SHA-256 hash of the string. This is a sample secret, and I will click go, and you'll see that Q says, hey, I'm going to create a plan. This may take a few minutes. I'll actually edit this video, so we'll fast forward through the minute or so of waiting that it will take Q to generate the plan. Okay, so we can see that Q created a plan. The plan has, it's got steps in order. It's going to say within test organization function test. So it knows about my, or it's aware that there is a function test project that has tests in it. It's going to add a new method, a new function called test is request signature valid. It's going to create a new instance of the function class. So it walks me through the different scenarios, testing scenario, expected outcome true, no other changes, and it tells you about its approach and how it's going to handle this. Would you like to generate a suggestion for this? You'll review a diff file. I'm going to go ahead and click generate code, and it's going to go ahead and do some execute on its plan. And I'm going to go ahead and same thing, I'll edit the video just to make this fit within the a little bit shorter time frame so you don't have to sit and watch it. Okay, so Q has come up with the suggestions. It is going to make changes to this particular file, the test project. Note that it also says some suggestions contain code with references, so I can go look at the MIT license from a particular repository that it pulled from. And then I can either provide feedback on what it's going to do, or I could say insert the code. I'm going to just go ahead and insert the code. The code has been updated. Would you like to work on another one? Nope, I think I'm done for now. And with that, I'm going to switch back to my file explorer or solution mode here. And I'm going to go open up the function tests project. And I'm going to scroll down and below my existing method, which was fact test function gets repo, there's a new method in there now. Test is request signature valid. And it's broken it out into a range, act, and assert, which is really nice. And so that's it. That's the end of the demo. I just wanted to show two quick examples of Q generating code and actually using that developer agent. To get started with Q, we have a lot of resources online. You could start on the aws.amazon.com website with the URL on the left to get started with Amazon Q. There's also a community site at community.aws/amazon-q, which has a lot of community-provided content and examples and projects that people have done. With that, I'd like to say thank you very much for watching this video, and please follow me on LinkedIn at linkedin.com/in/KirkDavis.